Okay, I'm in Braemar again, and today I'm basically going to do a bunch of starter quests that exist in the Hidden Vale. So most of these, you pick them up in Braemar. I imagine, I don't know for sure, that Braemar will be one of the starting locations for one of the three paths when everything is all finished. So there are a few missions to pick up. The first one is from this guy over here. We'll chat to him. He's Bodan. He wants some help. Wolf. I wrote this in my journal. If you can bring it down, he will reward you. Fine. So the next one we want to pick up is in the tavern. Have I gone the right way? Yes, I have. Here's the innkeeper. Flynn. Can I help you? Notes this in my journal. We should probably ask him what his name is. Flynn Gilson. Because we'll need him to advance the quest later on. So that's that one picked up. Now, the next one, or the next two, over here. Villager. Let's find out what she's called. Bridget. Raymore. So she asks you a question, you say yes, and you write a Bridget's request in your journal. So these missions are all fairly straightforward. Most of them will provide you with some gold, which is quite handy when you're just getting started. Some of them will only provide you experience, although the experience is not explicit anymore the way it currently works. The only other person we're going to ask this barmaid, can I help? Now I'm collecting this mission now. She's going to ask about her friend Kelly. Oh, I should have asked her first because she wants us to have Bowden about Kelly. Okay. Well, you know, you live and learn. I'm not actually going to do this mission anyway today, but it's the next step on. Oops. Next step on after you've completed the missions in Owl's Head, which is where we're going to get to. So, I need to find Bodan again. Just check with him about Kelly. So, you could come back and do all this later, of course. For some reason, it's recording the locations of all the things again. I didn't even know I've had it before. Let's ask him about Kelly. Is there anything we can... No, he just wants to talk about the... Anyway, so we're not going to worry too much about the Kelly issue at this point in time, because like I said, I'm not going to bother doing that one today anyway. So although all of those missions point to, well, a lot of them point to Kingsport, I'm not going to head there straight away. I am first going to head up towards Owl's Head. Because when you get up there, there'll be some more missions to accept, which you need to go to Kingsport for. So I'm gonna get all them first, and then head to Kingsport. On the way up, we'll deal with this wolf pack leader for Bodan. All right, so I'm on the Overland map in the Hidden Vale. So the Braemar mission is actually in this forest here. I'm going to leave that till last though on the way back, because that's actually a more challenging area than all the other ones involved. And probably I'll die a lot, so it might take a few goes. So into the South Railway, we're going to find the Wolfpack leader. Now the Wolfpack leader is up this hill. He's not here, but we do need to kill some wolves on the way up. Let's improve my speed and who do you want it? Trip the wolf. Didn't work. Ooh, ice fist. I think I've got him. Another one there. Let's see if I can just skin this one quickly. No, I can't. Oh, I'm not attacking. Three rolls at once. I'm just going to back off. The entrance. So I can take one of them out. I think I got one. Yep. Quick heal. And let us skin the wolf. And go back and finish off the rest of them. I'm levelling up everything at the minute. Look at that. Right, so this is a lower level area, so you should be able to manage it when you're just starting out. Let's see if we can just finish off skinning this one. There we go. Let's kill that wolf. Defaults to that, but it does. Let's do a flame fist and an ice fist. Combinations, eh? Can't run away from me. So we're wiping out all the wolves that are just in our way and levelling up, which will come in handy later on. The wolfpack leader is through the gap in the rocks there that I'm heading towards and just clearing out everything on the way. Oh, come on, get your sword, get your bow out. Oh, let's do one of them. Didn't work. Do a bit of a heal. There we go, everybody's dead, Dave. So yeah, you see I can deal with one or two. Well, I suppose I'm not a starting character completely now, but I'm not armed up to the teeth and all that. There's some iron there you can harvest if you're that way inclined. I'm gonna nip through the gap here to get to the wolf pack leader. Oh, there he is. There he is. Come on then. Oh, I'm running out of arrows. I might need to buy some more of them. But we're going for it. I think we'll have him. There we go. One more wolf. I've run out of arrows, so I'll need to buy some more. I might be able to take him out in the meantime. Let's have a health potion. Let's have a focus potion. Oh, I can't do any of that, can I? Oh, I can do that. Cool. So he's running away from me now. Oh dear. Because I've not got any arrows left. Well, let's ignore him for now. Skin the wolf pack leader. And get out of here and buy some more arrows. Oh no. Let's not bother skinning the wolf pack leader then. Let us escape the South Railway. So you see that line I wrote of this in my battle journal? That's what you're looking for as far as completing the quest is concerned. But I'm not gonna go back straight away. So now that I've used up all my arrows on the wolfpack leader, I'm gonna head up to that's back to Braemar. I'm gonna head up north. From the South Railway, because of course it always brings you out facing in a random direction, nothing at all to do with the way you went in. But there we go. So Al's head is at the top of the road up here, over the hill. North Railway is a nice area for beginner characters, nice level 1 area with a variety of enemies. Watch out for the spiders though. Pretty handy. Right, so into Owl's Head. Alright, I'm in Owl's Head. It is actually now 4 days since I first started attempting to make this video, but the Owl's Head stuff was bugging out at the weekend. So I'm trying it now in the middle of the week in the hope that when it's a bit quieter it will all work a bit better. So to review, I've picked up a bunch of quests in Braemar. I've done one of the quests by killing a leader of wolf pack on the way up the road to Owl's Head. Now we're in Owl's Head and we're going to try and pick up some more quests, which along with the Braemar ones or all get resolved, or the next steps for them all is going to be in Kingsport. So there's 3 quests I want to pick up. The first 2 are in the Fire Lotus Tavern, which is just here. If you saw my Explore Owl's Head video, you'll know where it is. So in we go with a little bit of lag. a little bit more lag. So the first quest is it's similar to the Braemar one, in Anton the Bart, oh sorry, Thomas wants some ale. So we're going to go for keep the tap stopped. And he's not going to respond. Okay, so it seems like he doesn't want to give us a quest still. I'm going to carry on anyway. The Guard Winslow issue is something we'll get to in a minute. I do want to buy a mug of beer, I think, unless I already have one. Do I have a mug of beer? No. Let's just get two. Oh, I've not got any money. That's because I've been buying arrows. Let's sell the corpse wax. Go for it. We've got two mugs of beer. So we're going to ignore Thomas for the minute. Let me assure you, he does normally have a quest to do with the beer. What we shall do is complete the quest anyway and then come back and see if he'll reward us for it. Right, so this bloke, let's just ask him what his name is. Morton, right. Going that way. He doesn't really want to talk about it. Unless we give him a beer. Morton's looking for a mug of beer. And now you can see why I bothered buying one. There we go. I updated my journal with Morton's new talkativeness. So let's try going that way again. And he needs a ledger. I write about this journal in my journal about this task. So that's it, we have the quest. So we should now see in our active quests Morton about his ledger, Flynn Gilson, who's looking for ale shipments. The barman here is also looking for an ale shipment, but I think the quest is buggy at the minute. So what we'll do is we'll complete the requirements for Flynn Gilson and see if the barman there is more appreciative when we come back. So that is the plan. There's another quest to pick up here in the main guard's office, and also a bit that will advance the story of the quest, that the girl running off with the bandits when we come back, but I'm not going to do that in this video, as I've said before. Sorry, madam. So there's a wounded guard who we discussed with the barkeep at the Firelighter's Tavern. We know it's called Winslow. Sorry, he's called Winslow. Go for it. Hello, guard officer. Hail, stranger. Can I help? Let's go for what is your name. It's always easier. He's not responsive. There we go. Guard, Captain Dreyfus. You can call me sir. Well, that's nice. A matter I'm charged with. So there's a guard. So this is the same story that the barman told us at the Firelighter's Tavern. And now it's in dire need. There we go, I write about this in my journal. There's an alchemist in Kingsport Market that carries a supply of healing herbs. Okay, goodbye. So that's the three quests. I've successfully picked up two of them. One of them seems to be bugged. But all of them now. So those three quests here, the quests I picked up in Braemar, all of them now require me to go to Kingsport. So that was the point of collecting them all together, really, just to make the make it be less running around in total. Now I could just quit out of the game at this point and start again on the world map, but I like to run through the town, really, like I'm actually travelling around the world. Skip ahead in a video about 45 seconds if I'm currently boring you to tears. Otherwise, we'll just keep on going past the cow and the skills trainer and the people sitting down and the sheep. When we get to it, here are the sheep, a cow, sheep, guards. It does look quite pleasant in the sunshine, owl's head, doesn't it? I presume, is it autumn? What does it say? August. So like we discussed in previous videos, the whole timeline is now actually tracked to the real date and time at a scale of 1 hour per one day. So what I'm not sure about, so I see there are some trees with red leaves. Well, I don't know if they've just basically, are the leaves set in colour or will they change through the seasons? I'm going to look out for that next time. Anyway, back in a minute. Okay, so after yet another client crash, I'm back on the Hidden Vale, and we're going to head down to Kingsport. It's not far. An escape prisoner there. So here where it says King's Road, cut around to the left, and Kingsport is there on the coast. Chaos Crossroads is a PvP area, if you're into that sort of thing. Let's go into Kingsport. So, we'll deal with the two alchemists first. There are two different alchemists. One of them is Morton's wife. Let me just rearrange all of this after it crashed and reset the settings back to what we were for. There we go. So there's an alchemist shop just at the end of the bridge there, and there's also an alchemist in the market. So let's trundle over the bridge. Trying to avoid the guard. There's an alchemist shop. In we go. Hello, alchemist. So we're ignoring the shopping stuff at the minute, and we're going to go in here. Oh, and we've lost a load of a load of things. Let's go for what is your name. What is your name? Her name's Alicia Morton. Owl's Head. Let's discuss the ledger. Time to bring it up. Give me the ledger. Do you reckon if he gave it, if I give it to you, he'll be able to find out where Harry and writes? Lie to Alicia. You received Morton's ledger from Alicia the alchemist. So there. Goodbye, Alicia the alchemist. That's nothing we can do about any of that at the minute, because I've no money, because I've spent it all on arrows. Now there's another alchemist around here in the little market. Oh, fire and elemental, looking a bit cool. Here's an alchemist. Let's talk to this one. Julie the alchemist. Winslow. This guard you speak of injured. Herbs. I've received healing herbs. So that's two of the two Owl's Head things done. Now we're gonna do the Braemar one, and hopefully we'll be able to then complete that third Owl's Head one anyway, even though he wouldn't really talk to us. So first we need to speak to the tavern, the innkeeper here. Flynn Girlsop. Ah yes, Braemar and Owl's Head need Owl. So it's, he knows. Why didn't the guy in Owl's Head talk to me about it? I don't know. Now they depend on the broken anchor. We need to speak to Anton. Who it turns out is some sort of smuggler. So I've written notes about that. He has more things to say if you want to chat to him. I'm not going to bother doing that in this video. None of the things are currently that relevant with, you know, the state of the game as far as the plot stuff is concerned. Now Anton is down here on the docks in that house there. So I'll try and navigate at night. Let's have a bit of light. Hey look, I'm leveling up. I'm leveling up in my ability to make light. So we go in here. There's a dock worker. Inverted quotes. Now she also wants to talk to you about people that have gone missing. That is not something I'm going to do today. But if you're doing the full, if you're gaming normally, talk to that woman. To see if you can pick up a quest. I'm not sure if it works in this release. Alright, let's try with the Flynn Gilson again. Ale. There we go. That's what we need to say to him. Ale. Alright, so you may have gathered, stranger. This is one of those problems that we have found our niche in solving. Please inform the good barkeep Thomas that Anton of Kingsport has a solution to his empty tap. The rate will be dear but fair, and everyone will profit. Although, not us until we speak to Thomas. So there we go. So that's most of the quests dealt with. Most of the starter quests. We can head back to Owl's Head now. We can fall down the stairs a bit. find the way up again. There it is. Avoid the people. So heading back out of town. The same way we came in. I don't think you can get out any other way. Maybe you can swim out, I'm not sure. Obviously you can use the boats to get to faraway places, but I think this is the only way out of the map on foot. Mostly clear, dusk. And back in a minute. So, we need to go back up to our head. We've got some sort of escort here, that everyone wearing the same cloak. It's quite easy to find even in the dark. Just go straight for a bit, then you go right for a bit, and you head up towards the north. Kink this way. Kink that way. Wait till it says our head and click enter. There we go. So it's dark again. Let's get some more light. Nice crown. So first things first, let's head to the tavern and resolve all of that if we can. You should know the way by now. There's a bridge. Walking into someone's sign. Mojito. I don't know why the dog gets a name, but the guards just get called guards by default. The sheep don't get names, just that dog Mojito. I wonder if he's representative of the pet of one of the developers. Oops, missed that. There we go. Cow, hello. Guard, hello. More guards. Sheep, sheep, sheep. So let's try talking to the barkeep one more time. Thomas. Let's try talking to him about Flynn Gilson. See if he knows anything about it. No. What about Anton then? He's not sure what I mean. From Kingsport. Oh, there we go. Get a proper lager reliably. The Antimfolio. What needs to be done? Boom! 500 gold. So maybe what I need to do is talk to him about Kingsport the whole time. Notes for future reference. Don't just believe that because text is underlined, it's going to be of any use to you. But having met Anton, we have resolved the issue and we've got 500 gold. Our first tangible results of this little quest, I suppose you call it. Let's talk to Morton. Hail Outlander. Ledger. I'm very talkative. Full complete sentences all the time, see? Morton's Ledger. Here he goes. Give items. Okay. So, I'm not sure that he gave us any gold. Did he give us any gold? Yes, he gave us 500 gold. I must have missed that. So I've gone from no gold to 1,000 gold in very short order. Basically, from running around, which is always handy. Now let's sort out Winslow. I don't think Winslow pays us. I'm fairly sure he doesn't actually. But it will lead on to the next part of the story, as far as the Hidden Vale story part is. I don't think any of it's really complete yet. In the old days, before this use-based skilled stuff, we used to get lots of experience for doing this quest. I'm not sure how it works out now. What mine at the minute? I can't tell. Herbs. I'm like Hulk. Healing herbs. Give items. And I received an elixir. Go to Winslow, say I have your medicine. Leave me be, please. I have your medicine. Elixir for Winslow. Go. And so he is healed, it appears, and quickly dictates a report to us, which is then goes into our journal. Let's just review that for you. A load of crap I did already. Load more crap I did already. Go on. There we go, right, here's Winslow's report. So you get to read the reports of what happened and everybody died. And you should give the report to Lord Enmar, is what you should do. And he's upstairs. So we'll just do that. Like I said, you're not getting paid for this one. But I think you will get some experience in the bank to use to level up. I've learned to perform salute, which is always handy. You don't get to see it because we've got some weird angle. Let's go for report. Help. Excellent. Bounty. So the red sashes, that's something that comes up. The red sash bandits ask you pursue the other quest. Oh, if I could say oh goodbye, that would be quick, wouldn't it? Pursue the other quests in Braemar. The barmaid who was worried about a friend who's fallen in with bandits. Spoilers, they might just be the Red Sash Bandits. So it all sort of fits together, which is very nice. While I'm loaded with gold, I'm going to speak to Theo the blacksmith, and I'm going to buy some more arrows. Let's have another 100. Okay. Now, is there anything? Epic leather boots. None of it looks to be any better than what I'm wearing at the minute. And learned violence. Ooh. I could buy some leather leggings. How much are they? 124. Plus 4% fizzle chance. Let's get some fortified leather leggings. Okay. Anything else? No. Done. Let's put my new leggings on. Bit more fizzle. But also a bit more protected. So The last thing I want to do before returning to Braemar is find that poor woman's husband. In case you don't remember, I'll refer to it in my journal. I spoke in Braemar to a sweet young woman named Bridget, who was waiting for her from her husband. So I left this one to last, because he's located in a slightly tough area. Well, I say, you know, it's a two-skill area, I think. We'll check when we go in. This is still a beginner character, so it's a bit advanced for me. So my plan is, since I know where he is, you know, metagaming and all that, is to run in, talk to him about his wife, and hopefully complete the requirements of the quest before I die, because I probably will die. Lots of wolves and stuff. And then we'll head back to Braemar and put that poor woman's mind at rest, because we're just good people who do that sort of thing for our friends and neighbours and, you know, NPCs. I'm sure you all do. Again, I don't think we don't get cash, but I think there's experience involved, which you then, of course, convert into skills. Where's the way out? Oh, there it is. We're into skills by doing stuff, allegedly. Okay, so I'm going to head down back to Saxon Light. Head on back towards Braemar. And Vaymor, Bridget's husband, is in the woods north of Braemar. Now, I personally find that massively vague. Vague to an annoying extent, because, you know, basically there are six or seven woods north of Braemar, which is quite annoying. But what they mean is, so here's Braemar, let's go north, not quite north, if you keep going this way, you end up in West Ravenswood, and that is what they're talking about, West Ravenswood. Alright, I'm in West Ravenswood. There's the gate, so let's just check. So, like I was saying, see, there's two skulls on the pole. Most of the other areas we've been in so far are one skull areas. So I'm going to try and not get lost here in the semi-dark. So Vaymor, if you basically follow the path, I would not get off the path if I were you, unless you've leveled up significantly since the start. So you want to follow the path. We're looking for this. There's a rock formation we're coming past here on the right. And what we want to do is look for the end of the rock formation. And then we want to... Ooh, how convenient. Somebody has been round and killed all the wolves. Which means Vaymor is standing here. Oh, somebody's attacking us. A large brown bear's attacking us. So let's ignore the large brown bear and talk to him about Bridget. Excellent. Goodbye. Let's try attacking the large brown bear. Tripping the large brown bear. I might be able to take it. It all depends on whether I get a healing potion up before I die. Maybe I will. Oh yeah, I did it. Excellent. So, like I said, if someone... Oh, there's a wolf now, look. Let's leg it. If someone hadn't very kindly killed all them wolves before we ran up there, that would have been a very difficult thing to survive. But someone's good to us. Now let's run away. I'm sure the last grey wolf will give up in a minute. Yes, he has. Let's do some more healing up. Might as well get some levels out of it. So, back to Braemar to finish everything off. So we went north to get to West Ravenwood. So we can see in Braemar to the south, there it is. Not far away at all. Alright, so to wrap it all up, we need to head back into town. In the dawn light, or whatever, late night, it's saying. So there are three people we need to speak to. Bodan the Hunter, to tell him about the wolf. Now Bodan tends to be hanging around behind the houses. That's not him. He's one of the bald chaps. Goodbye. Let's ask him what his name is anyway. Ooh, magical arts. Good man. Okay, so he's responsible for protecting the village from the undead. We still need to find Veymor. Perhaps I've gone the wrong way and he's actually on the other side. Not Veymor, Bodan. We found Veymor just now. Oh yes, this looks better. There's Bodan. Talk to him. Wolf. 250 gold for killing the wolf. Excellent. So you can see these quests. When you're a starting character, this money adds up. You don't have to do a lot of combat to complete them. Clearly you have to kill that wolf pack leader. But you can probably do the Veymor thing, even if you don't get lucky as I just did. With speaking to Veymor. Okay. 200 gold, there we go. Yeah, my usual click on things that gives you money. But yes, so you can see how for a start character these quests soon adds up with the amount of gold. Remember, I bought armor and stuff and arrows, which is nice. So finally, is it in here? Is this woman? There she is. Hello, Bridget. Raymore, is that his name? Yes. I have naught to reward you. Okay. But she gets a bit repetitive for that. So that was a quest that before we went to Skills Way just gave you a bunch of experience. I presume it still does give you something along those lines. And the barmaid is part of the story quest that I didn't pick up in Owl's Head to do with Red Sash Bandits, but you can do that if you want. So that has been a collection of Hidden Vale starter quests, which make you about 1500 gold better off. Not too strenuous. Only one thing you absolutely have to kill to complete them all, and that's that wolf. So if you're looking to sort of bootstrap your character with a bit of gold, you can do all that in, you know, how long has it taken me? An hour maybe? I'll have to see how long it is once I edit the video together. So fairly straightforward. Lots of money. Check it out. The start quests in the Hidden Vale.